Today we are going to turn this image to this and add some special effects with the free Snapseed app. Before starting, a big shout out to my channel members for the support. I'm going to first start with this image from which the sky will be used as the background. Starting by going to Lens Blur tool and changing to Linear option. Turning down the vignette strength and transition and moving it to bottom. Now increasing the blur strength to about 70 and applying it. Now I'm going to darken this with the Curves tool. Next, going to double exposure, I'm going to add the main image and increase the opacity to 100 and apply it. Now going to the masking screen. With the image hidden and brush value set at 100, roughly revealing the subject. Now zooming into the maximum and with the brush value set at 0, carefully brushing on the edges to reveal the background sky. After completing the masking work mainly around the top part of the subject, I'm going to zoom out and remove the mask at the bottom for a seamless transition between the foreground and the background. Fine-tuning the masking. Going back and removing the blur at the top of the sky for a more natural depth of field. Now I'm going to add a bright light behind the subject using curves. First, brightening the image overall and adding reds and greens for yellowish tint. Going to masking screen and applying the effect where the subject would be. You can see the effect here. You can notice the white smoke here, which is distracting. To remove it, I'm going to use double exposure and add the main image again. And increasing the size so that the parts of the smoke is covered with red soil around. Setting the opacity to 100 and going to masking screen. Just tapping on the smoke to cover it. I adding a selective filter on it to make it look a little more natural. Darkening the overall image again and applying this time at the bottom. With curves, brightening the overall image again with yellowish tint. Applying it again in and around the front of the subject to make it more interesting. A selective filter on the green gear to pop the subject more. Again, darkening with curves. This time masking work for a vignette effect by removing the darkness around the middle of the image. Now I'm going to add this image of fire with sparks to make the image interesting. Let me get back to how I edited this fire image to make it work on the image. Opening this image separately, I first darkened it using curves so that the darker parts are completely black. Adding saturation and warmth and saving it. Adding the same image with double exposure and moving it slightly to the left so that the sparks are around the middle. Then using the perspective tool and scale option and dragging it to the right to get this blurred motion effect. Doing it a couple more times and saving it. Now we have two images of the fire sparks. Now adding the first saved image with double exposure and choosing add mode, which removes all the black areas from the fire image, placing it somewhere on the right. Masking work to get it right. Making sure to remove the sparks on the plant, which is in the foreground. Now adding the second image of the sparks. You can try your own way to make it look more interesting. Added the same a couple more times to get it look like this, which is the final result. Hope you found some useful tricks here and subscribe for more. Thanks for watching.